हेलो लर्नर्स, आई एम मेनका चौधरी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एजुकेशन, महर्षि दयानंद यूनिवर्सिटी, रोहतक. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ICT एज लर्निंग रिसोर्सेज, ऑडियो, वीडियो एंड वेब रिसोर्सेज. डियर लर्नर, एज आई ऑलरेडी सेड, द मॉड्यूल इज बेसिकली डिजाइंड फॉर डिस्कसिंग द टॉपिक ICT एज लर्निंग रिसोर्सेज, बट मेयरली डूइंग सो विल बी इररिलेवेंट. इट इज़ नेसेसरी टू सेट अप अ सफिशियंट बैकग्राउंड सो एज to grasp the meaning of main theme. For this, apart from the main theme, we shall discuss in brief the concept of learning resources, ICT and its use in education, and relevance and importance of ICT in education, teaching and learning science. Learning is an important and essential activity resulting by some task of teaching, which is intended to transact some knowledge, skills, experience, attitude, etc. from the learned to learner. To help the learner learn effectively and readily is the chief aim and objective of all curricula, local or national. Inability to produce the learned knowledge or skill whenever required is no learning at all. A good teaching strategy includes all those methods and techniques which make learning interesting, meaningful and permanent. According to Department of Education Canada, learning resources refer to any person or any material, whether acquired or locally produced, with instructional contents or functions that is used for formal or informal teaching learning purpose. Learning resources assist teacher in his task of teaching science more usefully and enable learner learn science more effectively and efficiently. Learning resources may include human or non-human resources. Let us discuss about the physical or non-human resources. That may be text material, books, assignments, worksheets, etc., animation, images, pictures, painting, graph, chart, etc., audio clips, video, films, etc., models, object, instrument and devices, educational tour and excursion, internet, open educational resources and website, etc. It can be online program, ebook and Wikipedia, etc. Now let's discuss about the human resources. Human resources includes different living human beings which may help student learn and acquire basic knowledge and skills in science. That may be teacher, parents, elder, sibling, friends, expert in science, scientist, technologist, and social worker working in the field of science. Dear learner, let's discuss about what is ICT. ICT refers to all those technologies which are required for generation, processing, and transmission of information either face to face or to some distance location. It includes those entire electronic and communication devices with software applications to generate, store, convert, process, transmit and receive information from anywhere, anytime. Here, information refers to the knowledge, skill, experience, etc. in a variety of form like text, slide, audio, video, animation, etc. The invention of latest and sophisticated technologies has made the conversion and transmission of information easy and efficient. Every walk of life has been dominated by the presence and use of ICT in one or the other way. ICT include the following component. First of all, that is hardware component. It contain solid state device having definite physical appearance, which may be input devices, keyboard, mouse, trackball, joystick, output devices, printer, display devices, plotter, speaker, and the storage devices. Software part include program having set of instruction to facilitate working of computer, for example, operating system and application software, which may be MS Office, MS Paint, WordPad, Player, etc. Next component is network. which means interconnection of different computer located at distance that may be small or large, for example LAN, MAN, WAN, internet, and data which mean information in raw form, that is text, slide, images, audio, video, and the next things are user interface and the database. Education is no exception untouched by the effect of ICT. Education has also started exploiting the potential of ICT to broad scale. Effectiveness of ICT over traditional method of teaching in most of the subject has been ascertained by various researches. ICT has enabled all the stakeholders of education, that are teacher, learner, parents, administrator, supervisor, to execute their function effectively and efficiently without any error. This has started increasing the output of overall education system. ICT has a relevance in the following educational field: teaching and learning, evaluation and examination, administration and supervision, research, maintenance and storing of record for longer time. Dear learner, we discussed the concept of ICT and its increasing importance in the field of education. Let's now proceed to the discussion of ICT as a learning resource, especially in science. Let's first discuss the relevance of using ICT in classroom. As you know, school students are naturally curious, which makes science an ideal subject for them to learn. Science allows students to explore their world and discover new things. It is also an active subject containing activities such as hands-on labs and experiment. This makes science well suited to active younger children. Science is an important part of foundation of education for all children, but unfortunately, science, though a practical subject, still it is taught with traditional methods, aiming at memorizing the facts and reproducing in examination. Most students find it a tough subject, full of monotony and boredom. They slowly divert from the subject and their chance of lifelong learning are minimized. Aim and objective of teaching science are meaningful. Under such circumstances, it becomes pertinent to develop and adopt new and fresh methods and manner to make teaching and learning science interesting, meaningful, appealing, inspiring, and fruitful for both teachers and students. According to NCF 2005, which brought radical changes in the methodology of teaching and role of teacher in the classroom, all the traditional methods and practices have become obsolete. Awareness and knowledge of ICT has become vital for a teacher to be used in his task of teaching. We can now think how knowledge and skill of using ICT in the process of teaching and learning science may prove productive and useful. Now let's discuss in brief the importance of using ICT in teaching science. Use of maximum number of senses of learning, making learning meaningful, interesting and permanent. Facilitate easy and smooth flow of learning, eliminating the barrier from the path of learning. Motivational level and chance of success of learner are enhanced, arouse curiosity, encourage idea and spirit of question among the learners. It helps learners to develop higher order cognitive skills like critical thinking, imagination, etc., developing analysis and synthesis skills. Individualization of instruction is possible through ICT. We shall now focus on the use of ICT as learning resources in the teaching and learning of science classroom. ICT has a good relevance for teaching and learning science, which is purely based upon hands-on activities and experiment. ICT make many difficult term and concept, complex phenomena, tough experiments, etc., easy to understand and comprehend. We shall discuss following as important learning resources, that are audio-visual and the web resources. Audio-visual aids are also called instructional material. Audio literally means hearing and visual means that can be seen. So all such assisting devices which help learner to make the knowledge clear to him through his sense are called audio-visual aids and instructional material. All these learning material make the learning situations as real as possible and give us first-hand knowledge through the organ of hearing and seeing. Therefore, any device which can be used to make the learning experience more concrete and effective, more realistic and dynamic can be considered audio-visual material. According to another definition from Good's Dictionary of Education, audio-visual aids are anything by means of which learning process may be encouraged and carried on through the sense of hearing and sense of sight. Audio-visual aids have following benefits. First is use of maximum sense. It is based on maximas of teaching, that is simple to complex, known to unknown, concrete to abstract, and learning by doing. It maintains interest and attention of the learner. It reduces verbalism. It provides first-hand experience to the learner. It helps in clarifying subject matter. It caters to individual need of different learner. It provides reinforcement and keep learner motivated. It develops higher faculty of mind. It facilitates new learning as well as transfer of the learning. A teacher of science may use following aids in his teaching learning process. First is science kit. Science kits serve as a laboratory. Educational science kits are designed to supplement formal classroom education. These kits contain lab equipment, material, manual, and references to be hands-on to provide a holistic learning to the learner. Science kits provide the opportunity for learning by experience and make learning easy, interesting, and enjoyable. Display slides. Slides present the matter in the form of picture which we change manually. They may be used for emphasizing and discuss more important scientific concepts. Slides are well organized in a logical manner, cover the complete subject matter to be discussed. Audioscopes. It is a device which is used to enlarge and project the material like pages, images, pictures, diagram, and figure on the screen, which attract the attractions of the students. Projector. It is an optical device which is used to present the instructional material in the form of electronic slides, pictures, audio, video, etc. on the screen. It has the facility to display slide manually or automatically. It may contain the audio or visual element also. Students find it quite interesting and understand many difficult concepts in an easy way. Next is tape recorder. It is a device which is used to record audio, sounds of different animals, birds, and lecture of prominent scientists and specialists can be taped and can be reproduced before the student when required. Next is radio and television. Radio is one-way device which help only audio component. Many important program of science given by many experts in the field may be listened to the student. It increases the curiosity of learner. TV is also a one-way device, but it has the facility of both audio and video, which appeal maximum sense of learner. Many channels have been started by some reputed institutions like NCERT, IGNU, to broadcast important program in science, mathematics, agriculture, etc. Student may find these program worth watching and it may enhance their knowledge awareness about science. Next is apparatus and material. Teacher may use a wide variety of material during instruction in classroom or laboratory, which may appeal to their ear and eye. It include pictures, model, chart, real object, instrument, etc. He may show the student multimeter, ammeter, voltmeter, battery, key, wire, while discussing about the Ohm's law. These objects help to grasp the meaning of Ohm's law. Video and film. Teacher may attract the attention of the student by showing them small videos of some important lecture by expert or scientist, some important experiment, physical or chemical phenomena, biological process, films with scientific importance may be shown to the student. It helps develop scientific attitude among learner and interest in the student. Visit and excursion. Small visit or excursion to place of science or museum which may prove fruitful for student. It gives them opportunity to watch many scientific objects, phenomena with their eyes which they can never forget. Web resources, services and utilities located online that allow you to find, use and share information to accomplish some task. A web resource is anything that can be obtained from the World Wide Web. Some examples of World Wide Web are web pages, email, information from database and web services. Web resources are essential learning tool in this age of technology, which can be effectively utilized for learning many difficult concepts and complex phenomena of science by accessing these online available resources in form of video, animation, lecture by the expert, etc. Student can get useful learning material in the form of textbook, assignment, question paper, quiz, puzzles, videos and presentation which are likely to make their task of learning science very easy, fruitful and interesting. Hence, we can say web-based resources are supporting and helpful in facilitating smooth learning of individual learners. Both teachers and student of science must have sufficient knowledge of assessing and using these various online resources in their task of teaching and learning respectively. Following are the main requirements of using web resources as learning resources. First is infrastructure, that is availability of basic resources as laboratory, seating arrangement, light, ventilation, power supply, etc. Availability of technology, that is computer and other hardware devices. Connectivity for assessing the resources available online. Techno-friendly attitude of teacher and student. Digital literacy means basic knowledge and skill of using technology for assessing and using available learning material. Availability of time means you must have proper time. Web-based resources may be in the form of important website of national educational institutions like NCERT, NCET, IGNU, UGC, etc. Important web links or addresses where is laying some learning material in form of an ebook, video, animation, presentation, etc. YouTube channel containing lecture, demonstration of experiments or scientific activities, practical and working of technological devices, open educational resources, online digital platforms like Swayam, Swayam Prabha, which are initiated by Government of India. We have a list of web resources which will be quite useful for the learner and teachers of science. Let's have a glance over it. First is Kahoot. It is game-based platform to make learning interesting. Next is Discovery Education, the Physics Classroom, Science Friday, PBS Learning Media, Cell Alive, Periodic Table of Elements, Life Science, Science Buddies, STEM, National Science Digital Library, Science Net Linkings, NPTEL, Khan Academy, TESS India. There are some specific science learning online resources like 1 lakh stars, Ask to Astronomer, An Atlas of the Universe, BioED Online, Built by Kids, Chemistry Activities for Kids, Dynamic Periodic Table, Impact Earth, Khan Academy Science, NASA for Students, Eyes on the Solar System, NASA Image Archives, NIH Science, Physics to Go, Science for Kids, The Habitable Planet, LibroVix, etc. So, dear learner, let's sum up this module as we discuss about the role and importance of ICT in education, especially in teaching of science. And we also discuss about the resources, the ICT resources, mainly the audio and visual resources and the web resources. We also share a long list of software which a teacher and a student can use for their study material. Thank you. I think this module will be very helpful for you. Thank you.